Honor Club, where honor is real.
What do I think about the pure tournament and the decision? Well, in a word, basura, trash, garbage. What are you telling me here? I had Josh Woods in a single leg crab as time was running out. I knocked him almost unconscious with the royal flush. He had to use a rope break to save his life. That's like a boxer getting a knockdown in the 9th and the 10th and 11th and the 12th rounds, and the decision still goes the other way. It's like Ring of Honor, every year or so, they get this thing where they gotta screw Kenny King. Look at how I lost the Ring of Honor World Television Championship. There was a man hiding underneath the ring, tied my feet together. Do you think I ever got a rematch? I'm thinking about doing things a different way, right? I called Roosh. I called Dragon Lee. I told them about what I was thinking about doing, and they said, no problema. They said they'd handle it. So I got an email from a guy named Luis de la Torre. He's the Ingobernable Counsel. He's a lawyer. This is a letter that I got to read to the Ring of Honor officials. A quien lo pueda interesar. Estamos muy preocupados por el trato de nuestro cliente Kenny King. Es el mi... What? Oh, you don't speak Spanish? I gotta do it in English? Whatever, that's fine. To whom it may concern. We are very concerned with the treatment of our client, Kenny King. He is a very important member of our organization, and we find extreme fault with the decision of his pure tournament match. We will be pursuing action. So now that brings me to Shane Taylor. The reason where people sleep on Shane Taylor is that he's every bit as cerebral as he is tough. You need a dude like that on your side. So putting together the Rebellion with Shane, it really felt complete. And in this business, I'm very accessible, but I don't share a lot of all that I know with too many people. And Shane is a guy that I've made myself very accessible to. I can remember our very last match, and I beat him. And I felt a little bit of that spirit drop, you know, when you can kind of feel the soul taken out of you. And I consoled him. I don't know if I've ever done that in a wrestling match where I immediately go over to console. I looked at Shane and I told him that you don't know how good you're gonna be. Just because this was an obstacle right then and there, that didn't mean that you still weren't gonna be great, and I meant that. I'm in Ingobernable now. Shane's got his own crew. Shane understands what this is. I understand what it is. Shane Taylor has had a very successful career here in Ring of Honor after the Rebellion. He's had one of the most dominant world television reigns in history. So I know it's not personal. I know this is just business, but this is not a passing of the torch, dog. This is not a situation where I'm ready to give up my spot. I'm still here. I'm gonna be shutting your ass down like I did last time. I'm gonna be sending you back to the line like I did last time, because I'm not finished here. I'm still the K-I-N-G of ROH. You are definitely in my footsteps. But if you're in my footsteps, guess what that means? You're one step behind me, because I might have taught you everything that you know, but I damn sure didn't teach you everything that I know.